Hey friends, AE Shah's IAS Institute welcome you all to our YouTube channel where we bring to you such informative videos which are very helpful and beneficial for UPSC aspirants for their preparations. Now in this video, we are going to discuss the new black hole image that is running into news nowadays. In this video, you will get to know all and everything about the new black hole image. So this is the image of the black hole that has been captured recently. Now, scientists have finally captured the first direct image of a supermassive black hole. The highly anticipated cosmic portrait belongs to the black hole at the center of Messier 87, the largest galaxy we know of, about 54 million light years away. The new image comes from the Event Horizon Telescope, a network of 10 radio telescopes spread across the planet and functioning as if it were a single receiver, one tuned to high frequency radio waves. The image depicts an orange tone lopsided ring circling the dark shadow of a black hole that gobbles up matter 55 million light years away at the center of a galaxy known as Virgo A or Messier 87. This blurry first look is enough to confirm that Einstein's theory of relativity works even at the boundary of this giant apex, an extreme location where some thought his equations would break down. So the image shows the boundary between light and dark around a black hole called the event horizon, the point of no return, where the gravity of the black hole becomes so extreme that nothing that enters can ever escape. At the center of the black hole, time and space become so curved upon themselves that the law of physics breaks down completely. The two targeted black holes in the center of the Milky Way and in M87 are roughly the same apparent size when seen from Earth, because although the M87 black hole is much larger, it's also much farther away. So let us now first understand what is a black hole exactly. So black holes are extremely dense objects that nothing, not even light, can escape. As they eat nearby matter, they grow in size. Black holes usually form when a large star dies and collapses onto itself. Supermassive black holes, which are millions of billions of times as massive as the Sun, are thought to lie in the center of almost every galaxy, including our own. Ours is called Sagittarius A. Now, this question must be coming in your mind, that before this image, how did we know black holes even existed? So Einstein's theory of relativity first predicted that when a massive star died, it left behind a dense core. If this core was over three times as massive as the Sun, his equation showed that the force of gravity produced a black hole. Now, but until April 10, scientists could not photograph or directly observe black holes. Rather, they relied on indirect evidence, behavior or signals coming from other objects nearby. For example, a black hole gobbles up stars that veer too close to it. This process heats the stars, causing them to emit X-ray signals that are detectable by telescopes. Now, sometimes black holes also spit out giant bursts of charged particles, which is again detectable by our instruments. Now, scientists also sometimes study the movement of objects. If they seem to be pulled weirdly, a black hole could be the culprit. Now, what do we exactly see in the image? Black holes themselves emit too little radiation to be detected, but as Einstein predicted, a black hole's outline at its event horizon, the boundary beyond which light can't escape, can be seen. It turns out that it was true. The dark circle in the middle is the shadow of the black hole that is revealed by the glowing gas that sits at the event horizon around it. The extreme gravitational pull of the black hole superheats the gas, causing it to emit radiation or glow. But the gas in the event horizon isn't really orange. Rather, the astronomers involved in the project choose to color radio wave signals orange to depict how bright the emissions are. The yellow tones represent the most intense emissions, while red depicts lower intensity and black represents little or no emissions. In the visible spectrum, the color of the emissions would probably be seen with the naked eye as white, perhaps slightly tainted with blue or red. That's all. Now you might also be thinking that why the image is so blurry, it's not clear. So the answer to this is that with current technology, that's the highest resolution achievable. The resolution of the event horizon telescope is about 20 micro arc seconds. Now let me tell you, 1 micro arc second is about the size of a period at the end of a sentence. If you were looking at it from Earth and that period was in a leaflet left on the moon. If you take an ordinary photo that contains millions of pixels, blow it up a few thousand times and smooth it out, you will see about the same resolution as seen in the black hole image. But considering the imaging of a black hole 55 million light years away, that's incredibly impressive. Now another question might be coming in your mind, that how did scientists capture this image? Now over 200 astronomers around the world took the measurements using 8 ground-based radio telescopes, collectively known as the Event Horizon Telescope. These telescopes are typically located at high-altitude sites such as volcanoes in Hawaii and Mexico, mountains in Arizona and the Spanish Sierra Nevada, the Atacama Desert and Antarctica. In April 2017, the astronomers synchronized all the telescopes to take measurements of radio waves being emitted from the event horizon of the black hole all at the same time. Synchronizing the telescopes was akin to creating an Earth-sized telescope with an impressive resolution of 20 micro arc seconds, enough to read a newspaper in the hands of a New Yorker all the way from a cafe in Paris. Now, what they did after this? So they then took all these raw measurements, analyzed them and combined them into the image that you see now. Here in this image, you can see a part of the Event Horizon Telescope that was used to image the black hole. Why did then the scientists measure radio waves rather than visible light to capture the image? So the answer is they could get better resolution by using radio waves than if they used visible light. It is said that radio waves currently offer the highest angular resolution of any technique at present. Angular resolution refers to how well, that is the smallest angle, a telescope can discern between two separate objects. That is called angular resolution. So this is the reason why did the scientists measure radio waves rather than visible light to capture the image of black hole. Now another question, is this an actual photograph? Now as per Geoffrey Crew, who is the vice chairman of the Event Horizon Telescope, in the traditional sense, it is not an actual photograph. It is difficult to make an image with radio waves. The mission scientists measured radio waves being emitted from the black hole's event horizon and then processed that information with a computer to make the image that you see. Then, what's the conclusion? Does this image yet again prove Einstein's theory of relativity? Yes, Einstein's theory of relativity predicted that black holes exist and that they have event horizons. The equations also predict that the event horizon should be somewhat circular and the size should be directly related to the black hole's mass. Now in this image, you can see different parts of the black hole. This is the event horizon. This is singularity. This is photon sphere. It is the innermost stable orbit And finally, this is the accretion disk. So these all are the parts of black hole. Yeah, one more part that is hiding behind the question, that is the relativistic jet. It is, this part is called the relativistic jet. Now you must be wondering, that was it that easy to capture that image? No, it took half a ton of hard drives to store the black hole image data. Half a ton of hard drives. Well, that's very lot of it. Now, the newly released image of a black hole is a watershed moment for physics. Finally, we can put some of Einstein's most famous predictions from a century ago to the test. But it was not as easy as pointing a big lens at the M87 galaxy and pressing a button. It took years of work and the collaboration of more than 200 scientists to make it happen. It also required about half a ton of hard drives, as I said. Now, data collection for the historic black hole image began in 2017 itself with a coordinated effort called the Event Horizon Telescope. That isn't a single instrument, but rather a collection of 7 radio telescopes from around the world. The EHT, that is Event Horizon Telescope, used a principle called interferometry to combine the capacity of all those telescopes, creating a virtual telescope the size of the Earth. The Event Horizon Telescope had to collect a huge volume of data to deliver us this one image. The EHT team had to install specialized superfast data recorders on the various radio telescopes to handle the influx of measurements. The now famous image of a black hole comes from data collected over a period of 7 days. At the end of that observation, the EHT did not have an image. It had a mountain of data. Scientists like MIT's K.D. Bowman had to develop algorithms to take 5 petabytes of data and make sense of it. Yes, K.D. Bowman. This is the lady who is behind development of those algorithms. So 5 petabytes of data was developed. 5 petabytes is equal to 5,000 years of MP3 audio. There's simply no way to send that much data efficiently over the internet. It's faster to actually ship the hard drives to collaborators around the world. That's why MIT has 1,000 pounds of hard drives sitting in its haystack observatory labs. So now you know that it wasn't an easy task to perform, but still we did it. Yes, we did it. So that's all about the new image of black hole. For more such informative videos, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel AE Shah's IAS Institute. If you have any queries related to anything, you can always email us on aeshahs.ias@gmail.com. And for more details, you can visit our website www.aeshah.com. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Thank you so much for your kind attention and best of luck.